Ever spend hours crafting the perfect hook for your YouTube video, but when you film it, it doesn't sound like you at all? I'm going to share with you a secret feature within Canva that can help you sound a little more like you and a little less like a robot. As a bonus, I'm going to share with you another awesome tool that I found that's going to help you when you're brainstorming for your next video. The first thing you need to do is go to Canva. You're going to log in if you haven't already. At the same time, what you're going to do is open up YouTube Studio. Here's my YouTube Studio. It may look a little different because I've got Tube Spanner on there and I've got vidIQ, but essentially it should look very similar. You're going to go to the Content tab and find the video on your channel where you felt the most confident, where you felt the most like you. For this example, I'm going to grab this most recent video that I did, and we're going to go into that. What you need to find are your subtitles. Here we go. We're going to click subtitles, and then we're going to click edit as text. Copy this whole video. This is 15 minutes worth of text. Where I like to start when I'm doing this process are Canva Docs. So we're going to create a Canva Doc. I'm going to click Enter so that I'm out of the header space, and then I'm going to paste in that information. Of course, it's not formatted completely correct. I'm just going to take this first paragraph, get rid of the rest, because I think it's going to be a little much. Make some corrections. So sometimes the little red squiggly line helps, sometimes it doesn't. Here it didn't really help, but I'm just going to let it stay like this so that you can show that even if you don't make those corrections, sometimes it can be helpful. Go ahead and select all of this and copy it. Control C if you're on a Windows, Command C if you're on a Mac. Before we move on to the next step, Canva is always evolving. What Canva looks like on my screen may not be what you see on your screen. However, the information I share should still work. Things just might be in a different spot or named something different. What I want you to do is if I share a step and things look different and you're really confused, then just leave a comment with the timestamp. I'll see if I can clarify that for you. Let's get back to learning the skill. Instead of copying it, I'm just going to cut it so that it's not there because I want this to be very, very clear for you. The skill that we're going to use involves Magic Write, and there's a bunch of new features within Magic Write that you may or may not know about. You can get to Magic Write two ways. The first way is by clicking this quick action bar where it's a plus sign and you can click Magic Write. The second way is by clicking Magic Write up there and it will pop down. This is how you access this on this specific document type, which is a Canva doc. Either way, what you want to do is, do you see how here mine says the Creator Classroom? Yours might just say Magic Write, or it might say something else. What you're going to do is select the drop-down menu. You'll see I've got from your brand, the Creator Classroom, Magic Write, which is default, which might be what yours says if you've not added a brand voice to your brand kit. But you're going to also notice two others, informational and instructional, casual and conversational. What you're going to do is click one called Create a New Voice. Paste in the sample text. This is where that subtitles that you generated from your most confident video, or maybe it's the one with the most views or whatever, and you're going to paste that right in. This helps Canva analyze your voice. There is a limit to the number of characters you can add here. It's really amazing what it does. We're going to click Analyze Voice. It might be one of my favorite Canva Pro features of all time. This is what it described my voice as. Your writing is informal, and direct, creating a conversational feel. It uses instructional language to guide the reader through various steps, making the content accessible and easy to follow. Personal anecdotes and questions are employed to enhance engagement and relatability. I couldn't have told you what my voice was, but that nailed it. That's actually what I try to do when I film the Canva tutorials. Before we click save, it's important to name your voice. You can go with a couple different options. I might want to name this one Casual Conversation Instruction. Well, that's too many letters. Apparently, there's a cutoff on how many letters you can use. So let's go with Casual Instruction. We're going to click Save. Casual Instruction is in the drop-down menu. We can click it again, and you're going to see Informal and Instructional, Casual Conversational, Casual Instruction. I spelled instruction wrong. Not a big deal. It is time to see how this is going to work for you. Just like you can access Magic Bright two different ways, there are actually two different ways that you can use it as well. There's benefits to both types. So I'm going to show you both ways to access it. You're going to write something. The funny thing is about how we write, it doesn't always sound like our actual voice. I'm going to use discard changes because I don't want to make any changes there. What if I want to change this to sound a little more me instead of what's there in the description? Paste it in. I think it pasted it in white. It did. That's fine. It's an easy fix. I'm glad it did that actually because it happens. And so you need to know how to fix it. Highlight where you paste. And we're going to click text color on the quick action toolbar and then change that to black or something that you can read. We're just going to highlight over this and click Magic Write, click Change Voice, choose your brand new voice. So Casual Instructional. And let's see what happens here. Just a little word of warning. Sometimes this takes a while, especially if there's a whole bunch of people using it one time. So if it takes more than a couple minutes, then go ahead and refresh and try again. Over dull text in your vids. This actually does not sound much like me, but plus we've got six key things to keep in mind to make it top notch. Actually like this. I like that a lot. So I'm going to copy that, put it in my description instead of that. Of course, I would change we to I've. There are six key things to keep in mind to make it top notch. Yes. I like that better. So do you see, not only can you use it for your hook, you can use it for your YouTube description as well. I would love to thank the YouTube members who got to see this more than a few days early. If you want early access to the videos, all you need to do is click the join button and join the tier that gives you early access. Sometimes that means 3 days. Sometimes that may mean weeks ahead. The problem with this is that it changes your text completely. You see how it just changed that? I've got to click undo to get the original version back. There's a trick. What you would want to do is just copy and paste this. So here we go, and then you can do it there. The second way I mentioned, take this and click the plus sign. We can edit with Magic Write. Did you see that? We clicked edit. Let's do it again, just in case I went too fast. Quick action. Edit with Magic Write. Then you're going to choose the drop-down menu that you want. Maybe I want it to be informal and instructional. I'm going to show you in a minute how you can change the names or delete it if you want as well. So we've got this, and we're going to click generate. I've mentioned that this is a Canva Pro feature. If you are using Canva for free, this is a feature that you want to try. I will leave a link for a free trial in the description for you. Okay, let's see here. Oh, wow. So this one actually is giving me more information about it. This is where it could even help you with scripting. And in a few minutes, I'm going to talk about why it's really important to look at what the AI is generating and how that's going to make you go from a creator that just is using AI to an awesome creator. Okay, we're going to just insert this. I shouldn't have done that because I meant to show you something else. This is what I was going to show you. We're going to edit. We'll do the same thing. Generate. So the benefit of using it this way, you see it's creating, is that if it's not what we want, we can go back and say things like summarize for a YouTube description, summarize for an Instagram caption, maybe write 15 posts. Is that what we're calling Twitter X things instead of tweets? You know, like make 15 captions that are under 100 characters each, like whatever it is that you want. Here's what it gave me, which is a good base for a YouTube video. But we're going to click back arrow, and what we can do is make 15 variations, real caption, or maybe it's YouTube short captioning or description. And we're just going to see what happens. This is not one I tested before I filmed this. One thing I do want to mention that's going to take you from a creator that makes meh content that used AI to generate your stuff, and one that really sounds like you, in addition to using this brand voice tool, look at what I did. I used Canva Magic Write actually to create the document for this video. These are called highlight blocks. You can get highlight blocks by clicking the plus sign and searching highlight blocks. And there's a bunch of different options that you can use. I created possible hooks. I created possible titles. I don't know that I'm going to use any of these, but it was good to get my brain going before I pressed film. And then I brainstormed the full video for using brand voice. You may recognize this. I created this with brand voice, but then of course, what took this from script that's on the paper to even more of a casual conversational vibe that I love, that I'm hoping that you all love as well, is that I'm not actually reading the script. I'm using the script as a guideline that I can go back and forth. Oh, remember when I said before we move on to the next step, it's important that Canva's always evolving? I had it in the warning so that I could look at it real quick before I filmed that segment. I didn't actually read it. This helps me when I get stuck. Using Canva's brand voice can help you get unstuck, especially if you're just having trouble with your words that day. Do you remember when I said sometimes it takes a little while? It could be taking a little while because I went off the tab. It could be taking a little while because of what I asked it. Make 15 variations. That's a lot that you're asking. So if I wanted to do it again, I would just refresh the page and then ask it for a second chance. So I'm just going to stop the generation and then click go back and then click X. That's how you close out Magic Write. Did I miss anything? Oh, there's one more little tip before we get to the awesome tool that's right outside of Canva that's going to help you even more if you're stuck brainstorming. Let's click Edit with Magic Write. If you want to change something or delete it, so let me go to this one that's casual instructions, you can click the little, I cannot remember what this is called. Help me out, friends. We're going to click this. You can change your sample text there if you want it to be something different. Maybe some of your Instagram captions or YouTube descriptions or things like that. Put that in there instead and then analyze the new voice. Or look, you can rename it by clicking the pencil and renaming it. Or you can delete it. When you delete it, it tells you this is permanent. You cannot undo this. So make sure if you're deleting a voice that you really want to delete that voice. You can have, and as far as I understand it, it's limitless for Canva Pro users. You can have a lot of different voices. This means you could have one set up for Instagram. You could have one set up for TikTok. You could have one set up for YouTube Shorts. You could have one set up for YouTube Lives. You could have one set up for just about anything that you can think of. What about newsletter? Are you creating a newsletter? Maybe you have a different writing style than you actually have speaking voice. Add as many custom brand voices that you need so that it helps you push past the brain block so that it's easier to create videos. How do I know that this works? I know it works because I used it for today's video. I've been pushing off this video for 4 days now. When I sat down, I had the information that I needed that was a combination of magic write with the custom voice, my own manual input, a lot of it was my manual input, and one more tool. Following the steps you heard today, you can make AI sound more like you and less robotic. But what about that other tool that I mentioned at the very beginning of the video? Did you know that you can insert a public link of one of your existing videos into Gemini and give it prompts? What's Gemini? Gemini is Google's version of ChatGPT and Canva's version of Magic Write. But what are 5 video ideas I could make in a series based on this one video? We're going to click enter and see what happens. It's accessing the video, and then it's going to give me 5 video ideas that I could make that would work well in a series on that one video. You can let your imagination run wild when it comes to making these AI tools your brainstorming buddy. Mastering scripts, hooks, descriptions, it's only half the battle, right? Watch this video next to learn a Canva technique that can really improve the quality of your video. Stop procrastinating. Film the video.